We actually learn how to segment the liver out of the CT scan slide, from the open data or only a few data set. Then we use the interactive way to automatically learn from the doctor how to segment the tumor out of this CT scan. And through this interactive approach, we don't need a huge amount of medical image. We only need a small amount of medical image to study with. Then using the interactive way, we learn, the algorithm will learn from the doctor over the time.
那我们对 AI 的前景当然是抱持非常正面的态度来迎接它。对，那以现在来讲，刚刚你提过说是它是在辅助判读的部分，但希望未来可以做到跟基因的图谱结合，然后跟这些自动运算还有这个 computer 的 learning machine learning 结合，那把足够的资料量喂进去以后呢，它可以自动去学习，在对于说这个影像的判读上面更精准。
processing 在算，就是 loading 完会 pending 一下，然后 processing 就是正在算。
你要放大吗？
这个 CT 的报告的影响吗？
那这个话可以帮医生缩短这个判读有没有早期肿瘤的这个时间，那这些省下来的时间呢，就可以拿来跟病人解释或者是讨论病情。以我们单位为例的话，那是做完检查以后，大约等5到10分钟，我们就可以先把初步的这些疾病可以侦测出来，然后让医师有充分的时间可以跟病人做解释，这样子。
OK 了，有开机。
我们借由 AI 来判读这样医疗影像，那如果侦测到病人有肿瘤的话，那再搭配病人基因的资讯，我们就可以选择是否有适合的标靶药物来协助病人的治疗，那这样就可以做到精准的知道每个病人适合的用药是什么，来减少医疗资源的浪费。
有一个那个 blockchain 的东西的话，也已经登上了6项，也已经是里面最多的一个了。
A relationship between the doctor and the patient is M to M, is man to man. But right now the man, he become the machine to man. Yeah, still the M to M. But I think the first step will be, because the M to M a lot of a process in the middle, so we will replace the middle.It becomes by the machine. 手机放我们
这边。对对这个都是结吧。
The human and the computer or the machine interface is very important. So you should be as good as, okay? And because the traditional between the doctor and the patient relationship, okay? So I think, yeah, they will have a lot of improvements in research, but it's still a long way to go.